What up, ghost heads?
Welcome back to the Ghostbusters Fancast, a podcast supporting the Aquabat additional content. We're on Chapter 3 of IDW's Ghostbusters, The Other Side. We open with the Thundercat wanting to eat a child. That's the kind of cast we are. No, I mean, but seriously, there's a lion, ram, bat, fly, human pointing at a child he wants to eat that one of the Mafia Dons. That's right, right? The Mafia Dons have bargained the soul for safe passage for other spirits to the other side through a crack called the white light. We find out they are going back to the other side of the other side. So back to the living world, I guess? Yeah. But we meet some folks helping Peter Venkman, who just punishes the hell out of this thing. It's amazing. It's a gross scene if you're squeamish. If you're into dark comics, it's like child's play, though. Alright, so we meet some people assisting him. Elliot Ness, the guy who became famous for everything he did to try to take down Al Capone, and his team of law enforcement guys, the Untouchables. Jelly Bryce, or Jacob Adolphus Bryce, known in both the police and FBI as a fast draw and an amazing marksman. And then J. Edgar Hoover, the first director of the FBI and Pinko Commie Hunter. So it was demonstrated in the last issue when Peter, like, flew in and ripped out the spinal column of some demon. But he also throws an old woman here, which is hilarious, and comments on all the things that he can do here, which poses an interesting thought. If you don't die, but your soul ends up in purgatory, what happens? Souls that remain on our plane operate in a totally different capacity after they've passed on but come back. It's like it's by a different set of rules, or at least, you know, in the Ghostbusters universe we're talking about here. So I suppose I should couch that comment here in that kind of way. It's kind of neat that a human soul that hasn't died can go to the other side, purgatory, and have a different set of rules apply to it. It's interesting. Could be useful if you're into role-playing games, tabletop stuff. Like, that's kind of an interesting concept to toy with in a game setting. And then they do have like a role-playing game for Ghostbusters. We have my dude, this is so funny. I don't even All right, so it's my favorite frame of this entire comic, maybe of any comic. It's J. Edgar Hoover punching the shit out of an old lady and knocking her glasses off. The comic is worth that frame alone. It's so ridiculously funny. It looks like Heaven is aware of what's going on, and as it was put earlier, off the books, some of the things that are being done, and it sent Ness, Bright, and Hoover to figure out the details, meaning that it's not totally sure of what's going on, but that it knows something is. There's some other implications here in this comic. The comic covers it in a funny way, but, I mean, let's just lay it out. The reality of Heaven and Hell. Winston's former flame, now in a bikini in the afterlife, I don't know, has only heard of one person coming back to life, is something that she tells him. And, you know, that's Jesus. I think this is a nice callback, though, to the original movie where Winston and Ray are discussing the Bible. For reflection, here's what they talked about.
Hey, Ray, do you believe in God?
Never met him.
Yeah, well, I do. And I love Jesus' style, you know.
This roof cap is made of a magnesium tungsten alloy.
What are you so involved with that?
These are the blueprints for the structural ironwork in Dana Barrett's apartment building, and they're very, very strange.
Hey, Ray, do you remember something in the Bible about the last days when the dead would rise from the grave?
I remember Revelation 7:12. And I looked as he opened the sixth seal, and behold, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became as black as sackcloth, and the moon became as blood.
And the seas boiled, and the skies fell.
Judgment Day.
Judgment Day.
every ancient religion has its own myth about the end of the world.
Myth? Ray, has it ever occurred to you that maybe the reason we've been so busy lately is because the dead have been rising from the grave?
How about a little music?
Okay, so speaking of that, there's another observation here. While Winston is talking to Janelle, the ex of his, or it's not really his ex. She's not an ex. She died, but... whatever. So anyway, he's talking to her, and she comments that she believes there are larger forces at work, but she's in purgatory, and she doesn't know about the angels and demons guarding the borders. I mean, that's interesting. Oh no, there's a lot of stuff here that gets kind of compressed. The reality of heaven and hell in the Ghostbusters universe, the fact that even after you die, you don't quite know what's going on, but then we see what's going on. I don't know, there's a lot of interesting stuff here to me, because conceptually speaking, they're basically in the comic confirming for the purposes of the Ghostbusters universe that heaven and hell exist. So I'll be interested to see if they circle back and claim that it doesn't at any point in time. It might be an inconsistency, or it might not. I don't know. But we know demons exist in the Ghostbusters universe because of possession and stuff. Although we find out later that demons are just another type of ghost. So does heaven and hell exist? Like, it's very interesting how they lay it out. They say mostly that it's a thing in the Ghostbusters universe, but they always kind of call it into question. So, I don't know, I like that. Okay, so let's look at some of the folks involved in writing this. Drew Geraci and Jon Alderink, I hope I got those right, inked the comic. Drew's worked for all the major publications, including runs in comics with, like, The Avengers, Batman, Captain America. He was involved in Final Crisis, Infinite Crisis. He's done Iron Man, Superman, Wonder Woman, and on and on. You can look at his work on his personal website, Drew... Geraci.com. I'm not going to spell it. I'll put it in the show notes. In his gallery, he's got some amazing stuff. In browsing, I think he might even do commissioned work, which is pretty awesome. Okay, so let's see. Who was next? Joe Alderink. Doesn't have a whole lot out there on him, but looking through what he's been attached to, seeing Army of Two, G.I. Joe, the Gene Simmons House of Horrors. I mean, aside from the Ghostbusters. I'm going to have to look that one up. So with this, let's just take this out to Oingo Boingo, Flesh and Blood.
You flesh and blood. After all, we're flesh and blood.